Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Nemeseek, and we are continuing our coverage of IGN's exclusive images from the new Resident Evil Welcome to Raccoon City movie. In the last episode, we talked about the Leon and Claire image, and in this episode, we're going to talk about the STARS members, at least the four that are in the image here that I'll have on screen now that features them in the Spencer Mansion, which is really cool. We have Albert Wesker on the left, played by Tom Hopper. Richard Aiken by our boy Chad Rook. Shout out to Chad, man. Super awesome. Very active on social media. Very pumped for this movie and to be in this movie. And because of his excitement, I am now excited to see Richard Aiken in this movie, who's a character that I've, you know, kind of liked, but I never really thought too much about, even though he's on the cover of the first video game in the original one. But I'm excited for that, and Chad's an awesome dude. So shout out to Chad. And then we also have Hannah here, who's playing Jill Valentine, Hannah John Kamen, who does the piano intro for this show, because she posted on Instagram, and I kind of just lifted it. I hope that's okay. But I loved it so much. I love the piano. I love the sounds it makes, and she was very good at playing it. So this is her as Jill Valentine. And then we have Chris Redfield, played by Robbie Amell, my favorite member of the STARS team, and also my favorite all-around Resident Evil character, Chris Redfield. But Wesker's up there for number two, and seeing him over there, Tom Hopper towering over everybody, but without the sunglasses, that's a little interesting. So hopefully at some point he'll sport the sunglasses. Maybe at this point they fell off, and you know, when he's running through the woods or something, because you can see behind them, the door is open. They've busted into the house, and I don't know, our dog's going to chase him in. Like, I have no idea. But I'm interested. Like, I'm wondering why the door is left open when there's monsters running around. So, or maybe they don't know monsters exist yet. You know, maybe they haven't run into the dogs outside or anything. So anyway, I have, again, with this image, we're going to have some video game footage playing as well, featuring some of these characters from the Resident Evil 1 remake. And what we'll have here is the IGN interview, which I'll put a link to down below if you want to read it in full. But I've been going over, we're breaking into three episodes, and I've been going over some of the quotes from Johannes Roberts, who's the director of this film. And he starts off by saying that this is the team here prowling the Spencer Mansion, which in Roberts' own words is creepy as F, is what he says. So I'll go on to read some more of his quotes here, and then we'll wrap this episode up, and then we'll have another episode after this that focuses on the Lisa Trevor image, which I'm very excited to talk about. So here we have Johannes Roberts says, I wanted to go back to the horror of it all. I wanted scares and atmosphere rather than full-on action, Roberts told IGN when he was comparing what differences his movie has, Welcome to Raccoon City, from the previous Paul W.S. Anderson and Mila Jovovich films. He says, I think fans of the games felt the same. They wanted to see the iconic characters and locations and feel that the movie was more in line with the Resident Evil game world, so that's really why we chose to go in this direction. We worked hand in hand with Capcom on this movie to the point that we actually got blueprints from them on the designs of the Spencer Mansion and the Raccoon City Police Department in order to recreate them as perfectly as we could. We even have the exact artwork up of the mansion walls. So basically the wallpaper it matches the video game, basically. And he says Capcom saw it for the first time the other day and was so excited and happy about it. And basically when he says that, they were, you know, the other day, this is an exclusive interview and it's popping up now with these images, but this was an interview done on set months and months and months ago back when they were filming the movie. So again, you have context of, you know, when these things happen, even though they drop now, when he says the other day, you know, Capcom saw it, you know, he's probably meant on set the day they recorded this interview is most likely what he meant. Unless they, you know, Capcom wasn't there when they filmed it and they got put in a warehouse somewhere and then, you know, Capcom saw that in the warehouse. I don't know. But I'm going to assume this interview was recorded on set because that's typically what happens in most cases. So, that's all the news we get there. We don't got a ton about the team or the, you know, the STARS members or anything like that. So we got a little bit more information about Leon and Claire in the last episode, and then we get more about Lisa in the next one. But I just thought this was cool, and I just wanted to show off these images in a different way and break them up and not just cram them all in one video and just give you my thoughts on them, but also share this information from Johannes Roberts and these quotes to give a little bit more context to some of these images. Me personally, I think the set here looks great. In the last one with Leon and Claire, I thought the area they were in and like the sewers or wherever they were looked a little cheapish in some regard, like one of the walls did at least, or maybe it was just the way it was lit. But still, that's a minor nitpick. It doesn't make me scared for the movie or anything like that. But this shot is great. The STARS members coming into the house, just like in the video game for the most part, except that someone left the door open. and we have all the STARS members here. And I know we talked about this with Yvonne playing Leon in the last episode, but we also have, you know, Hannah here playing Jill. And I've already seen people, because these images came out before I went to work, so I got to see some fan reaction to it. And then, but you know, now that I'm home from work, I got to see a little bit more fan reaction from it before recording this. And it's always disappointing, I feel like, when fans get too hung up on things like, you know, the look of a character or whatever. In the last episode, we talked about Johannes Roberts saying that looking like a character is one thing, and that's important on some level, but being the character is more important to him because he's the filmmaker and he wants these characters to feel like they're more than just people showing up in cosplay. And I like that he said that. Now, whether that's executed or not, of course, we don't know until we see the movie, but I like that he at least addressed it and he's aware of that. And it sounds like he put in an effort to cast the people that he thought brought something to the role of these iconic characters. So to me, and I agree, I don't like, Wesker doesn't have his sunglasses on right now. I'm not really mad about that. You know, I made the joke earlier, like, hey, why doesn't he have them on? You know, maybe they fell off or whatever, but it's okay. If he's not, you know, Albert Wesker is not defined by his sunglasses. They are a piece of him in some way. But you know, they don't define him. And neither is Jill, like with her hat. Like I know people are like, where's her hat? You know, why doesn't her hair look like this or whatever? To me, those don't define characters. You know, it's nice to have them sometimes if you can. Like Robbie Amell looks very much like Chris Redfield. Some people are saying he doesn't look big enough. And I'm like, hey, Chris Redfield couldn't punch boulders in Resident Evil 1 or Code Veronica. So Robbie Amell looks great as Resident Evil 1 Chris Redfield, in my opinion. And Chad Rook back there looks great as Richard Aiken. So, and all of them, they all look great. You know, Hannah looks great as Jill. They look like a team and they're coming in, you know, guns ready, lights on. And I'm excited to see how this plays out. And you got Richard back there with his iconic shotgun. So I'm pumped. I mean, overall, I can't be mad at this. This is a step in the right direction. And it gives me, you know, it makes me smile, you know, knowing that that people are trying to do something that is true to Resident Evil. And you can hear it in Johannes's words and the way he cast. We talked about, you know, casting people in the last episode. He was like, I'm not going to get someone who just because they look like Leon, I'm going to get someone who can be Leon and act like Leon and act like the version of Leon we're writing for this movie. And same thing here with Jill and everybody else. So I don't mind it. I think it looks great. And this shot in the Spencer Mansion, I'm just so happy we're finally getting the Spencer Mansion. We've waited how many movies? We got 6 Milyovich movies and they were never once in the Spencer Mansion. And that was always aggravating. So this, I'm so happy about. So you let me know what your thoughts are, whether you agree with me, disagree with me, whatever it is, let me know down below. And also check out the full article if you want down below as well. And the next part, the final part, we will be talking about Lisa Trevor and Marina Mazepa, who plays her in the movie. I'm so excited. This is my favorite Resident Evil monster, and I wanted to save the best for last. So we're going to get into that in the next episode. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you in Raccoon City. Peace.